start with Patricia. So yeah, you can already come. So Patricia did her master's in industrial design and also a research fellowship in Politecnico di Milano. And 4 years ago, she came here to do her PhD at TU Delft. And she did her PhD together with the Research Oncology Center in Utrecht, yeah. Princess Maxima. And yeah, she's gonna tell us what she did the last 4 years. So.
Hi everybody, thanks for being here, and thanks Anna for your introduction. So today I will be here to present you to Mr. V and explain why he brings surprise. I'm briefly dive into the context of the project, then I will move towards the description of Mr. V, and then I will also give you some insight about the process and the challenges in the process. So, as you heard from the quick introduction of Anna, this is a project in collaboration with different parties that were interested in understanding how design and design research can be meaningful support in the development of children, specifically emotional and social development of children in the occurrence of childhood cancer. With childhood cancer, we mean cancer that occurs between 0 and 18 years old. So during the occurrence of cancer, children start to get treatment, and there is an intensive treatment that can last for years, and it can give a lot of side effects, but also after the finish of the treatment, there can be a lot of long-term effects. Throughout all the treatment, the children are supported not only through treatment, but also through psychosocial support when they are in the hospital. But if they don't have a high-risk cancer, they can also spend a lot of time with the family at home. That means that also the family gets involved in the context of the disease. And therefore, they start to struggle a lot with maintaining a sort of normality in their daily life. That means that communication gets hampered, but also the social interaction among the family members. Therefore, what I learned from the field is that actually the quality time that the children spend together with the family members, siblings, parents, and the extended family network is really important for their development. But it's often is overlapped with the treatment and with the motivation to the treatment. So what I decided to do was to focus on the home context and try to understand how design and design products can actually be introduced in this context and try to make them fitting better and become supportive for these families. In order to start my work, I started to get inspired by other research, design research that has been conducted time ago, and they can, in this kind of case, I try to look into elements that can be interested in design can be introduced in the home context. So finding examples that could work on inspiring users to get to reflect on their life, or, for example, become more aware about the rituals. Design that can be looked as familiar object, but also that can introduce a certain temporality in the context of the home. And specifically, I try to find specific strategies that could be interesting to introduce in the home context of those families with children. And I got inspired by the idea of this vending machine that all the family members recognize, children but also parents, and they associate with the idea of the surprise or a specific present that they want to receive, they are looking forward to receive. And there is also a connection with temporality, so the fact that you are waiting for a surprise. And from here I developed the concept of Mr. V, that was meant to become Mr. Surprise, that was meant to become a support, that was continuing the care that the family was receiving in the support, the psychological support the family were receiving in the hospital into the home context. So I started to develop the first prototype, and this is a research prototype. So I actually took all the vintage machine and I tried to hack it in order to make it work in the way that I wanted for the family. And the family has been invited basically to write down notes about small activities and little things that they like to do together. And I'd write them down on these notes and refill the little containers, the little balls, and then replace these balls in the machine. And the machine was working with a random timer, dropping those surprises every day during the week. We tested with the family and we obtained a lot of insights. Specifically, we understood that family were really cherishing the fact that simple daily things were turning into special magical moments, and that Mr. B was integrating in the family context because he was becoming a sort of a companion in the family. He was actually collaborating with the family in providing ideas every day. So from here, I tried to develop a new vision and introduce more elements that could connect to this magical effect and the surprise and the fact that children were always talking about stars and element coming from another dimension. And the new version of Mr. V is actually the one that you see in front of here, is a little astronaut. In the new study has been introduced with more features that can make it look like a final product, but also since the concept of the surprise has been already tested and was working with the family, I tried to integrate in more interactive elements that could help the family interact differently with the machine, but also in engaging more with the temporality. So for example, setting the timer of the machine during the week according to their routine. And now it's actually currently in under evaluation with the families. And apparently, all the family members are engaging with Mr. B. But now I move towards the process of this project in the background, and I would like to focus on three main points that are part of this process. So, the case of the prototyping parts related to the process, then the specific setting of the family, and then also the healthcare domain. And I want actually to focus on the challenges that make this project quite interesting. So let's start with the prototyping phase. So when we talk about research design, we talk about a process in which we want to use prototype to test ideas. But prototyping for sensitive setting actually increases the level of difficulties in this prototyping phase. Because a prototype then needs to be ready to be introduced in contexts where there are, for example, children. And that means that the prototype needs to be really sturdy. But also they need to work without any bugs, because it will create a lot of disappointment if the child doesn't see the machine working in the way it wants. It also needs to undergo a lot of certification and control in order to fitting exactly the normative to be introduced in a context with children and any kind of possible damages. And that means that you need to be really patient and take a lot of time to develop it further. I have learned a lot of things from this process of prototyping for this context. Specifically, that it's really good to have a good support network that you can refer to whenever there is a problem, but it can also suggest you a lot of implementation for the prototype. It's also really important to look into ethical guidelines to develop prototypes that can fit this context, and in particular that they have there are offices that can provide information about it. If you can have multiple prototypes to conduct your studies better, because it will reduce, of course, the time of conducting the study. And nevertheless, making but also writing about it, it takes a lot of time. It is quite difficult to go in parallel with the two. Let's move then to the sensitive setting of the family. So I mentioned that those families are dealing with a quite stressful time. And that means that sometimes they are not really willing to share every personal experience, or sometimes they can really get really emotional. So you need to learn to empathize a lot before starting to interact with them. When I talk about family, I talk about a group of users. So you're going to end up doing interviews with a lot of people in the same room, and maybe spending most of the time of the interview trying to catch the attention of a 5-year-old kid that starts to run around the house, or maybe start to talk with to play with the tablet, and he's not interested at all to the question that you want to ask. And those children are sick, so that means that you can schedule all the interview that you want, but then maybe a few hours before reaching the family, they will call you and say, hey, the child cannot do the interview because he's really sick. So you need to have always a plan B. And no picture, please. That's really a mantra in this setting. So we, as designers, we really cherish the fact of that we can take information through images and videos, but in this case, we are in a private context that is really, you need to pay a lot of attention in what you ask and what you take with you from this context. But also, parents are not always willing to share information and pictures about their children. So what I learned is that from this aspect of the process of meeting the family is that the family were actually really happy to have finally something that was addressing everybody at the same time and not only the sick child, so for example the siblings. And that is actually really interesting for them to have something that is not linked to cancer. So finally have something to play outside the context of the hospital. And it is empowering, it's really stimulating their creativity. And that give that chance to tell their own story and explain what they think about their experience. And it's really important to use the support from the hospital actually to address the kind of tools you want to use to speak with these families. And let's two slides. Regarding the healthcare domain, we talk about stakeholders, but also about normatives. So in the case of stakeholders, there are people that sometimes have no clue about what design is, design research means. And you need to explain that sometimes you make a prototype in order to investigate and explore and not really have a final product that they will work exactly in the way you want. And that they have a different way of working and a different way of approaching the research. So what I learned is that actually simple ideas for them, they learn that simple ideas can be really efficient with families, and that they maybe can start to introduce design in this context to explore differently the family situation. And finally, that normative and protocols are really important to take into account. So you will address maybe conversation with ethical committee, and you need to write your own protocol before starting the study. And that you cannot have direct contact with the patient because they are in treatment, so you need always to have an intermediate connection with the hospital. Okay, thanks.